Reeled you in with that sweet, sweet clickbait, didn't I? Well, if you'd kindly put down your pitchforks for a second, I'll explain why, in fact, I do think we should save the pandas. Pandas as a conservation icon are great. They're one of the last surviving megafauna that we as a species haven't wiped from the face of this planet, making them pretty cool and unique, while at the same time being cute and useless, winning over people and opening their cold dead hearts to the wonders of conservation. So yeah, I guess they're alright. However, I didn't call this video "Pandas are great and we should keep saving them," it's called "Stop Saving the Pandas." While this statement is a bit misleading, the general message is still there. Which is basically, we are putting way, way too much focus on big fluffy things while other, more important things are disappearing at an alarming rate. But Lynx, what could possibly be more important than pandas? I mean, look at them. Now, dear viewer, let's look at this under the cold, dead scientific lens to get a bigger view of the picture. Now, let's first take a peek at our slimy boys over in the Americas, the amphibians. Due to a somewhat underground event called global warming, things are heating up in the Americas, and as a result, the amphibians are having a hard time. According to this boring study, global warming will cause shifts in the American ecosystems that are favourable to diseases that infect a whole plethora of amphibians, rapidly accelerating the decline in the region. You may ask why this is an issue. It's only a bunch of frogs. Who cares? Well, the things that eat them care. Amphibians form some of the bottom rungs of food chains, being eaten by anything from birds, reptiles, and believe it or not, really big bugs. If this vital food source declines due to disease, many other species will be impacted by this lack of food, which could potentially have massive ecological impacts that could reverberate up the food chain and towards us. This doesn't mean that as a species we will start running out of food due to decline of frogs, but it does mean that the ecosystems we share this planet with will suffer negatively, and the natural resources available to us might shrink. Moving on, let's take a look at the bugs and beasties of the world. Unfortunately, due to a combination of two factors, we don't really know what's going on with the bugs of the world. These factors being a lack of interest in insect conservation as a whole, and the fact that most bugs are really small, meaning that it's hard to find out about the general health of insect populations, potentially causing the scientific community to find out about decline when it's too late to do anything about it. Due to this, we don't really have any sort of idea of how badly things are going for them. To put this whole thing into perspective, this paper published in 2005 said that at the time, only 70 insect extinctions had been documented, compared to 129 bird extinctions. This may not seem like much, but if we take into consideration the fact that there are way more bugs than birds in the world, the pieces should start to fall into place. Using statistics to illustrate this, take 1.3% of bird species that have been documented as extinct, and apply that number to 3.4 million insect species. Using this, we should have documented 44,000 insect extinctions. Keep in mind, that's only if they're dying at exactly the same rate as birds. For all we know, the little buggers could be dying at accelerated or decreased rates, we simply don't know at this point. But if the bugs are dying out as well, this could prove even worse for food chains across the globe, as bugs form even lower rungs than the previously mentioned amphibians, as almost everything eats insects of some description, meaning that if these boys went extinct, we could face ecological disasters around the globe. A similar paper published in 2009 takes a look at mollusk extinctions, and found that since 2007, the number of mollusk extinctions had almost doubled, and had a higher number of extinctions than any other taxa combined. The conclusion of this paper echoes in almost all the other similar studies and papers I read for this video. Invertebrate species receive much less publicity and attract disproportionately minor research effort related to vertebrates. If you think our beetles and beasties have received minor attention compared to mammals and other vertebrates, then oh boy, you have to feel for the various plants of this planet. While researching this video, I tried as hard as I could to find information on plants. I used the Web of Science, Google Scholar, my own university's library, and let me tell you, I found fuck all. The only papers I did find confirmed my suspicions. The conservation status of most plant species is currently unknown, despite the fundamental role of plants in ecosystem health. This is even more worrying than the lack of information available for the various invertebrates of the world, as plants are the fundamental producer for food chains. Nothing is below plants in the food chain around the globe. As most kids learn in school, plants are the primary producers in all ecosystems. With this knowledge, the lack of information we have available for the most important keystone to food webs around the globe is even more worrying. This video may seem lacking in information for the various domains I've covered concerning their status, and frankly I wish I knew more. I've spent as much time as I can spare in looking for papers, journals and studies on the general state of these creatures and plants, but as it stands there are a few bottlenecks. The fact that I am not as proficient as I would like to be at finding trusted academic sources, coupled with the fact that there is limited information on the general state of extinction and decline around the globe, means that this video was always going to be limited. However, I aim only to raise awareness to the limited audience I have, as this issue is massively important. This world is the only one we currently have, and the fact that the political classes around the globe seem to be very disinterested in conservation worries me. We only have so long to fix right the issues that we face as a species. If we do not address the issue of ecological collapse in the face of global climate changes, then we may very well face a bleak future. Well, I'd like to say that there are many ways you yourself can help the struggle to save biodiversity, but shy of voting for eco-friendly politicians, there is very little you as an individual can do. I mean, hell, if you want to, you can make a subpar video on the situation and spread awareness. That's what I did. If any of the new people who have subscribed, thanks Vale, have any interesting studies or think I'm wrong, then I encourage you to discuss in the comments. So far, this video has been pretty bleak. I wanted to end this video on a high note. So I've compiled a list of general feel-good articles and stories and I've edited them together over a song I think perfectly encapsulates the whole situation. So to wrap it all up, while the future may look bleak, always try to look on the bright side of life.
Always look on the bright side of life. Always look on the light side of life. If life seems jolly rotten, there's something you've forgotten, and that's to laugh and smile and dance and sing. When you're feeling in the dumps, don't be silly chumps, just purse your lips and whistle, that's the thing. Hey.
Always look on the bright side of life.
Come on.
Always look on the bright side of life.
For life is quite absurd, and death's the final word. You must always face the curtain with a bow. Forget about your scene, give the audience a grin. Enjoy it, it's your last chance anyhow.
So